Immediately after I do them, I feel like, oh, like I feel so much better. Before I do them, I'm like.
Beat it up like.
Hey y'all. Okay, so a couple disclaimers. There's a lot of shit going on with my skin. I'm telling you about it first so you're not just like, I know. Okay, I had a bad reaction to medication that I was put on. I don't feel like going into it just yet. My hair is wet, yes. I just have this thing where if I have a weave in for over a week, I have to wash it. If I plan on keeping it in for a little while, that's why it's wet, because it's clean now. Okay, I'm not trying to give you wet and wavy. I'm trying to my lips is dry. I said lips is all cracking. All right, okay, let's get it together. But yeah, my skin looks weird because I've been having all types of skin issues, and it's getting handled clearly. Okay, so my skin's gonna look like 10 different skin tones right now. You could kind of see like that line. I'm not getting close. I don't care. You can zoom in if you like. That's what you're into. But yeah, so let's get into it. I just wanted to have a little chit chat on a weird topic that I feel like shouldn't be weird. But I don't know. I just wanted to get other people's input or just kind of put my own input. All right. So the topic I wanted to talk about today is enemas. Whoa. First of all, I started learning about and doing enemas. I hate this lighting because it's just like, but I started learning about and doing enemas about, I'll say it's been 2 years now. And I just think that if you abuse them, it's not a good thing. But if you have stomach issues like me, my mom has always told me, you've always had a rotten stomach since you were small. Like, I got, you know, constipational issues. Is that a word? Constipational? Constipation issues. You know, I have heartburn. I get, like, stomach viruses and stuff like that kind of frequently. I don't know how, but I think it's because of the enemas. I swear to God on everything, knock on wood. Oh, it's over. 2019. I think is the first year I didn't have a stomach virus in a long time. That's bad. I shouldn't have a stomach virus every year, but I just feel like I contract these. I have a very weak, like, okay, so I got cut off. I have like a very, I don't want to say weak, but I guess I do kind of have like a weak stomach. I can't eat too many different things. Okay, blah blah blah, right? So I started learning about the benefits of using enemas, and I was like, all right, the tube is going where now? No, it's not. I'm not doing that. I don't care. Then I started learning more about it and stuff like that. And I was like, I just don't want anything inside my booty. But I got past that part, because then I was like, you know, I remember when my baby, well, he's not a baby anymore. Caleb just turned 8 years old. Wow. Stop. I think I started this YouTube channel when he was about to be 5. So that's almost 4 years now. What? So anyway, Caleb, when he used to get constipated when he was little, they have those little baby enemas that, like, you know, you can put in the tip, like, in their butt, and you just squeeze the little bulb, and then you hold their butt cheeks together, and then when they expel, it, you know, helps them go to the bathroom. So I was like, all right, if I could put a little tip in my baby's little booty, I can do it for myself if it's going to be better for my stomach, you know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be constipated and always taking laxatives to go to the bathroom or you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to. And suppositories, those are annoying too, and they don't really work. They just kind of get the beginning of the issue out. I'm going to put it that way. But I just want to say that for me, what I do is with my enema, I don't feel like showing it. Because I need a new one and it's not cute. I have to show it? I don't want to show it. That's embarrassing. Y'all know what an enema kit is. And if you don't, Google it. Enema kit. Not the little Fleets enema. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the bag. It's like a red bag. And it comes with a tube. and you fill it with water. Some people say they use tap water. Some people don't trust tap water. I use it because I don't care. Or you can get distilled water or bottled water. Who's wasting all that all the time? Or you could just get a filter, which I have had down here too. It needs a new replacement filter, whatever, in it. But you can get like one of those filters on your sink, you know, and I guess like the cleaner the water, obviously, the better. But worst comes to worst, you're brushing your teeth with that water, right? You're taking a shower in that water, right? You're washing your hair. It can go in your booty. It can go in, it's fine. You're not gonna die. So I can't believe I'm talking about this. I don't care. I think it's because it's so beneficial to me that it's like, I need to do a video where I am extremely backed up, but then that's weird too, and just show like the before and after of like when I do my enemas, because I feel like, is somebody gonna get that? Whoa. Can y'all even hear that? All right, no, okay, it stopped. So anyway, yeah, so basically, at least like once a week, especially if I haven't gone, I go days sometimes without going to the bathroom, and I've gone to my doctor and they give me the little Metamucil things, and that I'm like, I have to drink this every single day. And even that, I tried psyllium husk. I don't know if you guys know what that is. Google it, psyllium husks. And that's weird and gross, but I tried it, and it's like, I don't know what is wrong with my system, but the peristalsis, whatever it is that makes you go to the bathroom, I have issues with that. On occasion, rare occasion, I do go to the bathroom by myself. Is it like, can I hurry up and air dry so I can straighten it? It's not enough. Y'all know what I mean. But I feel like not a lot of people talk about enemas and stuff like that. And I have to do more research on them, because I just want to make sure that I'm not telling anybody to go and do it. I'm just telling you that it has been beneficial for me. Because immediately after I do them, I feel like, I feel so much better. Before I do them, I'm like, walking around, I feel all backed up and bloated and stuff like that. I just did one, and then I went to the gym after, and but before I did it, my stomach was like, okay. And now it just feels good. I feel like that's my flat tummy tea, okay? I feel like, I don't know if y'all know, but that's pretty much what flat tummy tea does too anyway. It makes you go to the bathroom. And I don't know, I just feel like that, and also, where is my stuff? That, and if you can stomach it, I'm sure a lot of people have heard about this, pink Himalayan salt. Girl, that stuff flushes the shit out of you, but I don't like it because it's gross. And you have to, I think, drink at least, don't quote me because I'm not sure, I haven't done it. Even like thinking about it, I'm like, but I think you have to drink 2 to 4 tablespoons and 2 bottles of water. And it might not sound like a lot, but 2 to 4 tablespoons and like 32 ounces of water, I believe that's how it goes. And it's disgusting, but you... There's a lot of rules to that and stuff like that. I could get deeper into that. I do it once in a while. And when I mean, like, the last time I did it was probably like 6 months ago, because I just hate it. But that supposedly is like a deeper cleansing for your system. And I guess that could be good to like boost your energy, make you not feel and look bloated, drop a couple of pounds in water weight. And also, you know, maybe kickstart you if you're about to start a diet, you want to have like a clean slate. But I don't really like that. And I guess it's like, either stick something up your butt, or drink salt water. Like literally it tastes like you're drinking beach water. Okay, I don't wanna talk about it, that's nasty. But it's beneficial, okay? Pink Himalayan sea salt. Flush, salt water flush, y'all have heard of that. So anyways, that's just my little quick take on my bad, what the hell was that? But that's just my little quick take on enemas. Like, it has really changed my digestive system. I feel like it helps me. And then when I'm sick, I can add to my enema of apple cider vinegar. And that gets hella mucus out. I know it sounds gross, but this stuff is really beneficial. I feel like a lot of people should try it. I'm not sure if it was it Katy Perry or... There was a singer, I gotta find out who it is, but she said that she feels like it's the fountain of youth. You guys should really try this enema thing if you can handle it. It's really not that serious at all. It's like maybe putting the width of it, maybe putting like a number two pencil up your butt. It's not even as thick as your finger. Yeah, that's all right. I'm just trying to give you... But I'll probably come back on and talk about it again because it's really been beneficial. I hate this lighting. I hate the way my skin looks, but it's all good. And my hair is drying on camera, so now it's really starting to look ratchet. But anyways, thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, I deadass does this. Like, I do this on a regular basis for myself, and I will continue to do it unless I hear some shit about that shit that makes you shit. All right, I'm gonna just stop. But anyways, yes, I think I have given my stamp of approval on enemas, and they really do help. If you don't know how to use it, then you might be like, okay, what is this? It's not working. But I think I should go out a little bit more depth. I just think it's a weird topic, but I felt like making a video about it because I see videos about it, but some of them are dated and some of them are just like, I can't explain it. Yes. If you have any questions, please leave it down below. And thank you so much for watching. This video is getting too fucking long. So, peace.